Based on the electricity that's traveling through this arena and decibel level of the crowd, I think it's safe to say the roof of this building just might blow off.
You know, after all the pre-match hype, I expect this one to be one for the ages.
Two superstars going head to head. I love it.
But we all know that anytime John Cena is in the ring, there's a war about to take place.
That move should do it. I mean, this should have been over a while ago. Come on, ref.
Yeah, this should be over.
The incomparable John Cena. King, what must he be thinking now?
It seems every arena we go to, he receives among the loudest reactions. The WWE Universe absolutely loves him.
What can I say about John Cena that hasn't already been said? He's an absolute thoroughbred, Michael. Plain and simple.
It's matchups like this that make the WWE the most popular spectator sport in the world.
I don't know if we've seen that from him before. I mean, it's definitely a first tonight.
This is great. This guy will try anything.
He's on the defensive here. I fully expect him to bounce back, though. This is the type of one-on-one atmosphere where he thrives.
And at this point, it looks to me like this match is as even as it could get.
And on top of that, John, these two guys couldn't be any more evenly matched at this point.
That may be the first time we've seen that executed.
John Cena shows us some clever offense here.
You know, there isn't a performer who's had a bigger impact in WWE over the past decade than John Cena. And sure, maybe he's got his share of detractors, but that comes with any territory when you go into every battle with as much attitude and perseverance as Cena does.
Debilitating impact to the spine, and John Cena with the cover. What offense John Cena is showing at this point. John Cena has really conquered as many challenges as one superstar can face in WWE, and that includes beating the odds when in that ring against opponents, coming back from near career-ending injuries, and always looking over his shoulder for the next superstar, looking to make a name for themselves at Cena's expense.
Well, you're right about that, Michael, and I'm sure Cena's battles are ones his opponents would like to forget. But I know one thing, John Cena always brings out the best in his opponents because he is always going to be at his best. There's no such thing as going halfway for John Cena. Whether it's his attitude, his effort, or his ability to be a royal pain in the butt to the no-good villains here in the WWE.
Just making his presence felt there. Well, that's the first time we've seen that move tonight from either locker room.
I gotta love it.
You know, King, every time John Cena steps into the ring, he steps into it like he is the C Nation's champion, whether that's true or not, no matter who the opponent or what the reaction of the crowd may be, in Cena's eyes, he is the good guy in every match.
Well, you know that's usually the case, Michael. If Cena comes across as the straight-laced, small-town guy who just happens to be a dominant WWE superstar, well, that's because he is. He's in full-on attack mode now. John Cena go here. Let's go. This match has taken so much out of this guy. He's not going to give up. But man, this has been physical.
Well, John Cena may like to play the squeaky clean All-American boy, as we said, but don't think he won't fight fire with fire when an opponent tries to stoop to some down and dirty tactics. John Cena prefers a good clean match in that ring, but don't get confused. He's fine if the match turns into a street fight. I don't remember the last time he executed that maneuver. certainly showing us something new from his repertoire.
That's cool. I like new stuff.
Oh, the reversal by John Cena.
Oh, and did you hear the impact?
I remember plenty of John Cena contests where John had no other choice than to start returning the favors from some opposing WWE superstars. Cena likes to play by the rules, but if an opponent is going to take things in a rule-breaking direction, then you better believe John Cena will fight fire with fire to the point that the devil will cringe.
Here we go. John Cena setting it up.
Oh, look at this. When you go at an opponent like this, it means you're out for blood. The WWE rule book goes right out the window. Trust me, it's going to get ugly.
John Cena is in the zone now.
Will it be? The elbow. They get dangerous out here, especially when there are no countouts.
Yeah, they could fight all over this arena for as long as they want to.
Well, when you look at the illustrious career of John Cena starting way back in 2002, and since then, 21 championships, an astounding accomplishment. And never a dull moment.
No, you're right about that. And don't forget the 15 World Championships. 11 reigns, of course, as the WWE Champion.
This is what makes him one of the best in the business. Wearing down the opposition here.
Cena with a slick reversal.
Oh, not again. Not again.
Oh, what devastation. You can't get up from that, can you? I don't even want to think about what a third time will sound like.
And the thing about John Cena that stands out, only Bob Backlund and Bruno Sammartino have more days combined as WWE Champion. In the 11 reigns as WWE Champion, we were just talking about, that, folks, is a WWE record.
He needs to dig way down deep if he wants to keep going now. Man, he's still down after that move. I almost wonder if his bell got seriously rung there. You know, Cole, more recently for John Cena, his reach extends beyond the accomplishments in the ring. We can't forget about that top 15 rap album that he released and his extension into feature films and television. This match has taken so much out of this guy. He's not going to give up. But man, this has been physical.
John Cena with the offense.
Oh, watch out. Two major blows with that weapon did significant damage. If this isn't enough to win the match, I don't want to...
He's just brutalizing his opponent with that table. He's just brutalizing his opponent with that table.
He's pulling out all the stops tonight. He needs to dig way down deep if he wants to keep going now. You know, it's remarkable. When John Cena has his adversary incapacitated, there's always the very real possibility that he will go to the submission hold that he has developed into his trademark, the STF.
Oh, yeah.
Cena doesn't miss many chances to lock that hold in, does he?
He anticipated that move perfectly.
Quick thinking to avoid that.
Man, he might need to get a new identification photo taken after this one's over.
You're not kidding. After this one's over, his own mother won't recognize him.
And when John Cena is able to lock in that STF hold that we were talking about, the result is pretty predictable. Very few. Oh, my. John Cena.
Oh, no way. Being on the receiving end of that finishing move a second time means this one might be over.
His opponent's in serious trouble. Well, this might be the worst yet.
Hey, he's going for it again. He thinks he has it.
Here's your winner.
Where's this going?
You know, with no countouts, he's more dangerous than usual outside that ring.
Yeah, he's one of the most dangerous superstars around. Uh-oh, this is the confrontation we've all been waiting for. This is what makes him one of the best in the business.
These superstars will do whatever it takes to win here tonight.
Wow, what a shot. Talk about battering someone. If there are many more of those, don't worry about the outcome of the match. Worry if we get a stretcher out here.
Back inside now.
Look out, John Cena is measuring.
Another knockout blow, that could be it. We have just witnessed the coup de grace.
Look at the emotion.